What's up, everybody? Welcome to a new English Beat. Today, I'm going to share with you the experience of running my first marathon. And at the end of the video, I'm going to teach some vocabulary related to running. Are you ready? So let's kick off. Without a doubt, Copenhagen will be always special to me, as in this city, I completed my first marathon on the 19th of May 2019. That day, one crazy dream of mine came true, and I couldn't be prouder. It took me 5 hours and a half to get to the finish line, but to be precise, the way to the marathon started about 2.5 years ago, when I took up running. To tell the truth, I had never been into running before. First, I started running for 15-20 minutes. In the beginning, the idea of running for an hour was something difficult to imagine, but little by little, I could run longer and faster. At first, going running a couple of days a week was enough, but what makes this sport special is that it's so addictive. My first race was a 10-kilometer one in Valencia back in November 2017. After that, I decided to sign up for the World Half Marathon in Valencia in March 2018, which I finished in under 2 hours. Then I started dreaming of a marathon. As I love traveling, I picked Copenhagen to run my first marathon and visit a new city. Although I never stopped running, my marathon preparation was fast and furious, just about 9 weeks of serious training. Little time on my hands added to a heavy workload I had to juggle, 2 extremely busy months that required a lot of hard work, commitment, and determination. The previous week before the marathon, I started having pain in my right leg, maybe due to the physical overload. When I arrived in Copenhagen, I kept feeling some pain, but was optimistic, hoping that it would disappear. Unfortunately, the day of the marathon, my leg wasn't better. Even so, I decided to run for as long as I could, because this marathon was very important to me. I had devoted so much time, hard work, and eagerness to it that I just needed to meet my challenge. So I took some painkillers and ran for the first 30 kilometers limping, much more slowly than I'm used to. Luckily, after passing the 30 kilometer mark, the pain vanished and I was able to speed up. Cut a long story short, after 5.5 hours of slow but steady running, I proved to myself that nothing is impossible if you really want it. I can say that I ran this marathon with one leg and my heart. I wanted to reach the finish line so badly that quitting was never an option for me. All this hard work had its reward in the evening, when we went to the restaurant chain Jagger, which treated all the marathon finishers to a free hamburger menu. Now I'm looking forward to running the same marathon again next year. This time, my preparation will be longer and slower, I promise. Can't wait to see you again, Copenhagen.